One of the world's oldest civilizations has, over the past few decades, witnessed huge transformation. For people in modern China today, especially the growing middle class, rising income levels are generating a greater range of choices. Among them is the option of changing their appearance. Plastic surgery here is on the rise. The industry is now worth $62.6 billion annually, a figure that's expected to double by 2019.
So why are more and more Chinese people going under the knife in the name of beauty? We're going to visit clinics and operating floors to find out what's fueling China's cosmetic surgery boom.
Our first port of call is a makeup room to speak to someone who's in the business of ensuring that people look good. More than 10 years, makeup artist Hu Lei has painted the faces of thousands of news anchors and TV stars.
Out of all the people that you, the celebrities or artists or you know, actresses, how many do you think have had surgery?
More than 60%, I think.
More than 60%. Do you worry that in China too many women are addicted to plastic surgery?
Yes. I think it will make people greedy, you know. You can't stop the desire of being beautiful, more beautiful.
This pursuit of perfection has become big business. The China Association of Plastics and Aesthetics is predicting astronomical growth for the industry over the next few years, making China the third largest market in the world after South Korea and Brazil. The majority of those opting for cosmetic enhancement are, not surprisingly, under 35. And again, not surprisingly, most are women. But the figures for men are rising sharply. In 2015, the number of men undergoing surgery doubled from a year earlier.
做一下双眼皮，我觉得我双眼皮比较好看吧，但我鼻子是自己的，剩下的都有微调一下。这已经是一个不是说一个很隐私的东西了，这是大家普遍都已经开始做这个东西了。漂亮吗？
漂亮就开心，比如说你花钱，你花个几万块钱买包包，买完包以后你可能可以开心几天，但是你变美的话，就是一照镜子，就是可以开心，这个感觉点是不一样的。
你喜欢韩国的有名的人吗？
喜欢。
啊，你喜欢他们的样子吗？
挺喜欢的。
While there are a range of factors driving demand, analysts agree that South Korea, the world's most cosmetically enhanced nation, is having a big influence on its Asian neighbors. South Korean pop stars, with their surgically improved faces, are hugely popular in China. That's also made South Korea a top destination for young Chinese seeking a nip and tuck.
We get the strong influence by the Korea. An oriental nose is so beautiful with this part, but some want them to be
a higher bridge.
High, yes, right. and they do it very wide, you know. It's just an avatar.
Avatar,
yes, yeah. Very avatar, you know. Yeah. This part is so strange, you know.
Right.
I can't bear that.
中国是一个非常传统的国家。讲究内敛科技的，中国有个语言叫做身体发肤受之父母不敢毁伤，理论上讲呢，中国人是不接受身体的这样巨大的像整形美容外科这样的变化，但是奇迹就是在经济高速发展，人们的需求突然间的奔放。
Another powerful driving force is peer pressure, particularly onlineSocial media platforms like WeChat and Weibo are often blamed for making us look at our self-image through a more critical lens. Cue face-altering phone apps and voila, you're a few clicks away from that perfect selfie.
So there are a ton of apps out there that people use to make their photos look a little bit more airbrushed. Take this Chinese one, for example. I'm going to take a snap of myself.It's going to upload, and now I'm going to play around with the settings a little bit. Let's change the color of my skin to make it
softer. Let's make my eyes look a little bit sparklier. Slap some makeup on, and there we go. What do you reckon? So say I fancy this photo of myself, posted on social media, the likes start to roll in, and I get that self-gratification that we all seem to be after when it comes to social media. You can kind of start to see how the advent of the selfie and how apps like this would kind of fuel a vanity craze.
Combine vanity with a belief that your life will improve once you've been under the knife, and the reasons for changing your appearance become quite compelling. To understand how the process works for those who choose to take the next step, we check out one of the growing number of cosmetic clinics in Beijing. Out in the city's west, Ba Da Chu began as a plastic surgery hospital, treating disfigured war veterans in the 1950s. But as demand for cosmetic enhancement grows, it's becoming a well-known destination for people wanting to change their looks.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you very much.
And we discover right away that patients don't need to rely on their imagination to conjure up their ideal face.
Now I'm going to tie my hair up because I'm about to have a 3D photo taken which will show my skin and my face shape, and then I'm going to go and have a CT scan which will come up with my bone density and my bone structure, and those images together will be uploaded to software which we can play around with the shape and structure of my face, and I think it might show how much technology is a game changer for this industry.
Obviously, the technology removes most, if not all, of the uncertainty. And being able to pick and choose what you'll look like after the surgery can only encourage the faint-hearted to take the plunge.
To go under the knife or not to go under the knife, that is the question. So this is an exact replica of my skull, albeit a rather smaller version of my skull, and it's the result of the CT scan. Now we're going to take that and combine it with the 3D image of my face and see how much we can make me look like one of the world's most beautiful women, Angelina Jolie.
Indeed, doctors say patients often come to them with photos of celebrities and say they want to look just like them.
It's more pointy, right, okay. So we're going to give me a pointier chin as well.
Sought-after attributes in the plastic surgery world include a V-line jaw, high-bridged nose, and so-called Barbie eyes. Some condemn the pursuit of these perceived Caucasian traits.
年轻人因为受到西方文化的影响非常大，也慢慢的也开始喜欢双眼皮、高挺的鼻子、比较扁平的颧骨，还有那个很突出的这个下颌。
你很漂亮，我觉得美人姐你外的人都会很小，比我小的话就能看就能感觉脸很小。
是外国人和中国人的脸不一样，
不是鼻梁很高，双眼皮都是欧式的。
为什么你喜欢这样子？
好看呢，大家都喜欢追求美的事物，就是吧，真好看，皮肤还好，还白，好羡慕呀，牙齿也好看。
中国人的面型，它比较宽大的，把这个多余的北大的这个下颌角。
They'll have this cut off.
Yeah.
Wow.
从侧面来看，这个曲线就会好一点。但是你呢，恰恰相反，你需要把这个骨质让它变宽。
You can visualize how your face can change, and in ways that you've never really perhaps thought of before. And I guess visualizing it, being able to picture what you would look like with these changes, kind of makes it all the more tempting.
24-year-old postgraduate student Yang Dongyan is at the Ba Da Chu to undergo her double eyelid surgery. It's by far the most common procedure in China.
I'm 昨天晚上失眠了，都太紧张了。
Young has forked out the equivalent of $720 for this procedure. That's a little pricier than most clinics in the city, but Dr. Jin has a reputation for sculpting the perfect pair of double eyelids. Dr. Jin prides himself on what he calls his oriental approach to cosmetic surgery. He believes in preserving the characteristics unique to Chinese eyes. Performing double eyelid surgery has become second nature to Dr. Jin. After all, he's been doing it for 21 years.
你舒服吗?
After just 20 minutes, Young's operation's over. Back at the hospital, 22-year-old Chung tells me she's excited about finally liking how she looks in photographs. Her surgery is a little more complicated.
So this young lady is just 22 years old. She's already got double eyelids, but she wants to make them more pronounced and deeper. She's also getting incisions here so that her eyes will be longer. She's kind of been whimpering through the whole operation. She's clearly a bit nervous, a little bit scared, but I guess that's the price she's willing to pay for beauty.
In not long, Chung will be graduating from university and entering the workforce. Job applications in China often require a photograph to be submitted along with a candidate's CV, a sign, so many people argue, of how commonplace is discrimination based on looks. That spurred a belief among young people that having cosmetic surgery is a shortcut to a better career. It's becoming a more common story in China as these internet celebrities, known in Chinese as Wanghong, gain popularity. They're known for hosting online videos and posting photographs of themselves wearing sponsored clothing, seen by their thousands of online fans. If you ask most people in China to tell you what a Wanghong girl looks like, they'll almost always give you the same description: pointed chin, round eyes, fair skin, and a high-bridged nose. In a recent survey, only 10% of China's internet celebrities admitted to having had surgical work done. Still, they all look so similar that Wanghong face has become a well-known term here. We visit Dr. Xue, who's built a reputation creating Wanghong faces.
I've done many surgeries to create some Wanghong. I'm a great affected by the Western culture, so I like the face to be more special. In a way, they call Hunxue. They are Chinese girls, but they have some features of the Western girls.
Wanghong 认为呢是远远偏离美学标准，锥子脸，大眼睛。 鼻梁口顶起来，眼睛巨大，外眼角一开，那个什么那个美瞳戴起来，把中间给我立体感全弄起来，顶起来。它比西化还西化，又不是西化。
人骨的形状呢？
那你还不如现在。
就起码那个是人骨，起码年久的，现在不知道得打折。
别到了。 就是想当网红是吧？
对，我一就特别喜欢网红。
就是网红。
怎么做这种？
芭比混血风都是网红款，
尽量呗。
对，做不了那么快。对。你想做成网红款的？
但是我不想要网红那么夸张的，就是比自然偏再偏一点夸张，不要特别夸张那种。
你觉得他们都不像一样？
好像一样，
对。
嗯。我觉得好看就行啊，一样就一样呗。我就想要这种小翘鼻。
To get a look into what goes on behind the scenes, we catch up with an internet celebrity who's so open about her cosmetic procedures that she now blogs about them. Although Chendada hasn't opted for one of the more extreme Wang Hong styles, her transformation is still quite dramatic.
This is the front, this is the back.因为喜欢就混血那种感觉，眼窝会显得深邃一点。之前矮的时候会觉得整个人就看起来很丧，不太开心那种感觉。然后这是我恢复完的，就明显可能感觉变化很大。
You look a lot happier here.
Like most of the people we've spoken to who have undergone plastic surgery, Chendada was motivated by a personal story. In her case, she'd chased a man for 7 years without any luck.She's convinced it's because she wasn't pretty enough.
Do you think the pressure from society impacts your decision to get surgery so much?
就比如说我领养的那个小狗，那可能我朋友其实之前是想要领养的，但当他看到他之后觉得他很脏，然后不太好看，他就说，那我可能要考虑考虑，我不想养了。然后我说啊，那我养吧。就这个可能是大家都不愿意承认的一个事实。对。
Society is a bit cruel to people that they don't deem good looking.
Chendada decided to go to South Korea, the plastic surgery capital of the world. With a new face, she hoped people would take to her better.
当时最难受的时候就觉得可能要挂了，就当时就是第一次做那个轮廓手术的时候，就是戴着那个氧气面罩。然后我手术完昏迷了12个小时，然后我去洗手间的时候看到镜子里的我就包着嘛，然后拿着那个挂着那个点滴，然后就被自己吓了一跳。我当时觉得哇，现在这么惨，我以后变漂亮了一定要就是做很多很多那种 to do list。
The 26-year-old says the operation changed her life.
其实我对世界的看法从来没有变过，对吧？变的是别人对我的态度跟看法。让我们一起来看一下瘦脸针。
Each week, Chendada hosts a video in which different cosmetic procedures are tested while she explains how they work to her 50,000 fans.
在我自己的公众号上面或者是说一些网站上面，我会去 po 我自己的这些视频，还有就是一些教程或者是一些贴士，告诉他们怎么样去合理科学的一些变美。
This week, she's talking about non-surgical procedures. One of them, botulinum toxin, or Botox, is now a hot choice among young Chinese women. There's a domestic brand available, costing up to $400 per injection, lasting for about 6 months.
In the West, Botox is often used to smooth out wrinkles, but here in China, it's used to give the impression of a narrower jaw.So Botox is a non-surgical procedure, much like hyaluronic acid, which is injected into the lips to make them look bigger. That's kind of what the Kardashians and other celebrities use to give them those big fish lips.
Non-surgical procedures, known sometimes as lunch break cosmetics, are becoming the industry's big sellers. Typically, they can be performed in an hour, less time than a woman would usually spend at the hairdressers.
Chendada is getting an injection into her legs to make them look smaller. I think they're already pretty small. Do you think you're addicted?
我觉得没有，因为我至少知道说我自己是想要怎么样子一种状态。就现在更多的可能只是一个保持的一个状态，包括年轻化。对，其他基本上大的项目是不会再做。
So when do you think you'll stop?
我觉得爱美这个应该是永无止境的，对，就像你平常化妆也一样。
While Chendada's path to perfection has been relatively smooth, achieving the ideal face can be risky business. Jin Wei Kun is an aspiring actress and the victim of a string of bad operations. It began when she made the decision to have a breast enlargement back in her hometown in Shanxi province.
当时造成的情况，胸部的问题挺严重的，国内的一些医生是没有办法来治疗的，所以说当时我就想到了是去韩国。我是金美坤。
With no legal recourse for compensation and not enough money to pay to fix the problem, she agreed to participate in a television show jointly produced by South Korean and Chinese companies called Bucket List 2. The deal was that the bill for her breast surgery would be covered, but she'd also have to have an additional 12 operations on her face. These operations also ended badly.Her chin was left lopsided, and the implant along her nose wasn't fitted correctly. Jin still experiences regular numbness in her jaw.
就是大众的眼光认为，好的节目里请到的医生肯定是一流的，真的谁也没有料想到会那么倒霉，是吧？这种东西，唉，反正命运吧，也是一方面，我觉得。
Her case isn't unique. Thousands of Chinese have returned from South Korea disfigured after being targeted by unregistered clinics. Back in China, a lack of regulation also seems to be an issue, especially when it comes to non-surgical procedures. It's estimated that only 20% of China's hyaluronic acid injections have been approved by regulators. According to the country's Cosmetic Surgery Association, the components are largely fake or smuggled, and up to 100,000 clinics are administering the injections without a license.
有一部分人吧，他已经失去了作为医生的本质，他们现在是一个非常合格的商人。
We all know that aesthetic surgeries.We can do a lot of money with it, but you have to be well trained. You have to be a doctor first. If you are not a doctor, maybe you are a criminal.
As the demand for plastic surgery in China grows, so do the opportunities to make big bucks. Dr. Xue hopes the industry will become more regulated as the market grows.Despite several more reconstructions, Jin still isn't completely satisfied with how she looks. She complains that her nose is too pointy, her cheeks too hollow. But she's pledged never to undergo major surgeries again and wants to focus instead on growing her craft.
在你表演的时候，你会觉得人生很真。
你是不是走错房间了？哎，你谁呀你啊？
因为在电影跟镜头里面，骗人的他就是个骗人的，大家都知道他是个坏人，对吧？好人他就是个好人，你不会觉得像真实的社会那么复杂。其实说到未来，我挺迷茫的，我也不知道。就是做自己喜欢的事吧，活好当下。
风雨过后不一定有美好的天空，不是天晴就会有彩虹，所以你。一脸无辜不代表你懵懂，不是所有感情都会有始有终，孤独尽头不一定惶恐，可生命总免不了最初的一阵痛。
其实人生就是这样，对吧？不一定每一天都会有彩虹，但是我们可以学着让自己变得开朗一点。
放心吧，
Every Wednesday afternoon, a long queue forms outside Dr. Jin's office. One by one, he calls the people in for a consultation. He tells us he refuses to operate on a third of them.Since he considers their requests unrealistic.
一般来说我们需要做一个充分的评估，如果这个病人的话呢，他心理状态很不稳定，我们是不能给他做手术的。
Low self-esteem is a common issue among young people. In China, the onus is on the doctor to deem whether someone is suffering from something more serious. This could be body dysmorphic disorder, a psychiatric condition in which a person has a warped perception of his or her body and is obsessed with changing it.
整容的这批求美者，他们的心理问题，我认为是个重灾区，应该得到更多的心理关照。但恰恰这一点是个巨大的空白。实际上，中国在各种文化里面有一个非常特色的文化，就是面子文化。在这种市场经济情况下，对人的外表越来越重视，一个看脸的时代。
I'm eager to know if, in striving for beauty, we've become a society obsessed with perfection, and what role the media play in this.
Okay. There is some concern that there's too much pressure on women to be beautiful. And then some would say that the fashion industry and the beauty industry, including magazines like Vogue, are perpetuating the problem. What would you say to that?
Yeah, I mean, certainly we celebrate beauty. You know, we celebrate all kinds of beauty, sophistication. But when we celebrate beauty, we also mix it with a sense of positivity. You know, I always say that a woman, if you look at me, I'm not like the traditional beauty, but I think I'm confident, I'm myself, I'm at ease with myself, and I feel that's fine. I work with so many models, with so many celebrities, I don't feel that I have a problem standing next to them. It's about how you look at yourself.
Yes. And does Liu Wen have that charisma?
No, I think from the beginning she was.
Liu Wen is not only hailed as China's first supermodel, she's also being championed for changing beauty standards in the country.
Yeah, she could have gone on the route of a lot of Asians. You know, she's slightly darker color, you know, relatively speaking. And she could do the Korean thing, you know, put all the white foundation, turn her into somebody else. But she did not do it.
Something else she didn't do was have double eyelid surgery. By celebrating her single eyelids, she's helping deliver a message to young Chinese women that beauty comes in all shapes and sizes. Angelica Jung makes it very clear that she doesn't judge anyone for undergoing surgery. However, she says it has to be for the right reasons.
The key question here is why you do it. If people, you go to do plastic surgery because you want to become somebody else, even if the plastic surgery, you know, that process was super, super successful, you are still not going to be happy with yourself. I really advise young girls to read more, watch good movies, travel more, open up their eyes and look at different lifestyles and cultures. And basically, there's no shortcut. The more you know, the more you learn, the more you look at yourself with a pair of clearer eyes. There's no way else to improve oneself. You just have to keep working on it. I'm working on it still.
下一个柜是了。
嗯，是我十一号。
先带我到十二号，先带我吧。十一，你先看十一号，你们在外头先等。
我是十二。
你再等着，在外头等，一个一个的看，在外头等。